guys, today I'm filming my Throwback Thursday of my November favorites from 2015. If you guys are unfamiliar with my Throwback Thursday series, I'll have my playlist linked down below. And basically, I am re-reviewing the products I featured in a favorites video 2 years back to let you know my current thoughts on those products, whether they are still favorites or whether I've replaced them with something I prefer. My inspiration for this series is Kristen Game. I'll have her channel and her playlist linked down below. I will also link down below the original favorites video, and I will list and link all the items that I'm mentioning. So jumping right into the video, I actually had quite a few favorites in November 2015 compared to the months leading up to it, but I actually don't have at least half of the products that I talked about, but I will still give you my thoughts on them and tell you why I don't have them anymore. So starting with complexion products, I did have a high maintenance combination, which I always tend to have a high maintenance combination. So for foundation, I was mixing together the Estee Lauder Double Wear in the shade 1 W1 Bone with the Hard Candy Glamouflage in the shade Porcelain. You guys, this is my holy grail foundation combination. I've tried so many different foundations and nothing compares to this combo. I love the Estee Lauder Double Wear formula. To me, this is medium buildable coverage. It has more of a satin finish. This is a little dark for me, unfortunately, but it is super yellow, which I love. And the only reason that I'm mixing it with a hard candy is because this lightens it. And the Hard Candy Glamouflage foundation is amazing. It also is medium buildable coverage with a satin finish, and the shade Porcelain is super duper fair, but it has a yellow undertone. This is my number one foundation mixer. I use this to mix with all of my foundations, and this works well with every formula that I've tried so far, which is really impressive. So this is incredible, way better than any white foundation mixer because this is as opaque as a foundation. So this is incredible as a mixer. I do like this formula as a foundation on its own, but as a mixer is how I like it best. This is still my holy grail foundation. As I've said a couple times, they did change the formula of this a couple years back, and it's not as good as it used to be. The original formula, the color was light enough for me. It was full coverage with a matte finish. And unfortunately, it has changed for the worse, but I still love this foundation. It is still the best that I've tried so far, but it is a little bit of a bummer that I knew how good it used to be and it isn't the same anymore. But yes, it's absolutely still a favorite. And then my concealer combo under my eyes was using the Maybelline Better Skin Concealer in 10 Porcelain or Fair, whatever the lightest shade was. And I mixed it with the Estee Lauder Double Wear Concealer in the shade Light. So for this concealer combo, I took the Maybelline right under my eye to conceal and correct. And then I took the Estee Lauder in the upside down triangle here, filled it in with the Maybelline, that way it could help to brighten. And that combination worked out really well. And I'm glad it did because the Maybelline was too dark for me. I find that with most Maybelline concealers, they're still too dark for me, even the lightest shade, which is so annoying. That foundation had decent coverage, it had a decent finish, but it wasn't anything that wowed me, and it's nothing that I ever repurchased. And the Estee Lauder Double Wear Concealer is amazing. So the shade Light is really fair. It has more of a neutral undertone. And then they also have a shade Extra Light, which is super fair and also very yellow. So I think Extra Light would be awesome for blemishes. And the regular light shade would be a great under eye concealer for me. And it gives a lot of coverage. I'd say probably full coverage with a satin finish. And this concealer is something I'd tried before Tarte Shape Tape was ever released. And I would say it's definitely on par with the formula of Shape Tape. Now you don't get as much product, and I believe the Shape Tape goes a little bit lighter, but I love this concealer. I would actually contemplate repurchasing it because it was such a great shade match, and I really love the formula, and that's a totally underrated product, and it's something I never would have tried if I hadn't worked at Estee Lauder before, so it's incredible. I definitely recommend that concealer. And then I had a face powder combination, so I was setting my face with the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in 100 Translucent. You guys know that it's my holy grail face powder. The shade is not actually translucent. It's very, very fair with a yellow undertone. It gives me some coverage. It helps keep me a little bit more matte. But sometimes when I use that powder, depending on my foundation combination, it can look a little too light. So to help adjust the shade to match me better, I was going over top with the NYX Mineral Set It Don't Fret It Loose Finishing Powder in the shade Light Medium. And unfortunately, it only comes in two shades, and Light Medium is a little bit too deep for me. But because it is a loose powder, I can get away with it a little bit more. So doing the combination of the light pressed powder and a little bit darker loose powder works really well. And I applied it with the Real Techniques powder brush, which is great to just brush it over to help adjust the shade, but without packing on too much powder. I still think the Maybelline Fit Me is holy grail. I do like the NYX loose powder, one of the best loose powders I've tried. I just wish the shade matched me a little bit better. It's something that I really enjoy because I felt like it just glides over pores and wrinkles without settling into them. It is something that I would contemplate purchasing in the future. And then I had some Estee Lauder cheek product favorites. I had just started working at Estee Lauder and I received a bunch of different products and had been testing them out, which is why I have so many Estee Lauder favorites in this video, because they were new products to me. So I tried the Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess Bronzer in the shade number 1 Light. And this is a nice light warm tone bronzer that has shimmer. So it was great to bronze, but I wouldn't use it to contour. But the shade number 2 medium is more cool tone and it is matte, so that would be good to contour. When you buy the bronzer, it's expensive, but it is like this size, the same size as the Wet n Wild Color Icon bronzers that are ginormous. That is how big the Estee Lauder ones are. It is a really nice formula and I did like it, but I didn't love it. And I had so many bronzers that I loved that I decided to give that one to my sister. And then I also had the Estee Lauder blush in the shade Pink Kiss, which is a beautiful pinky coral, definitely my favorite blush in their line. It had a beautiful amount of glow to it. It did perform well, but it was just way too expensive to be a standard blush. I like blushes from most brands. I'm not that picky with formula, and that was just okay, so I gave that to my sister as well. So neither one of those are favorites anymore. And then I had some Estee Lauder eyeshadow favorites, and you can check out the original video to see what they look like, because I have gotten rid of all of them. And the ones I was specifically talking about would be the Cyber Shadows, which are the same formula as a MAC Extra Dimension eyeshadow in the shade Cyber Teal, and then some of their regular shadows, two matte shades in specific, which were Wild Sable and Chocolate Bliss. So I really like the formula of these shadows. I thought these were pretty colors, and I did use them a lot when I worked at Estee Lauder because we want to be wearing the makeup that we're selling. But compared to other eyeshadows in my collection, they were just okay, and I never ever reach for them. I just have other browns and I have other teals that I was liking more and just was reaching for more. So the Cyber Shadows are awesome. They're really pigmented, really shiny. They feel a little bit dry when you're touching them. They feel exactly the same as MAC Extra Dimension. And then the matte shadows are really pigmented and creamy, but I just had other shades I liked better. And they just weren't the right tone for a lot of different looks. And unfortunately, all of those shades were discontinued. So you can probably find them at the CCO if you're interested. And the eyeshadows that Estee Lauder has now are such a snooze. I'm not talking about Estee Edit or Victoria Beckham. Like, their regular standard eyeshadows are so boring. They don't have any good colors. And I know that most of their customers are older, but if you want to bring in a new young crowd, maybe have some colorful shades or some good mattes. Like, I do not understand why they got rid of those shadows. They, in my opinion, they got rid of the best shades. Like, the ones that they kept, they should have gotten rid of those and saved the other ones. As I said, I wasn't reaching for them, so I did get rid of them. But I was keeping them in this Sephora Baby Z palette, which I mentioned in that video as well. You can buy this from Sephora and also Sephora JCPenney stores. This is in the display close to the Sephora single blushes and single eyeshadows too, I believe. This is only $10. So this is only $10 and it is the Style Baby. It isn't a small, a medium, it is a baby size. And I've only seen this size available from Sephora, but for $10, I think that is incredible. And I think it's awesome if you just pick up a couple single pans here and there, or if you want to give it to somebody as a gift, $10 is an amazing price. So right now I just have some ColourPop eyeshadows in here, Colored Rain, MAC, just some random overflow shadows. And this is like my random brand eyeshadow palette. I do usually keep my ColourPop shadows in a different palette, but I'm using that for my single shadows of the month. So I move my palettes around, but usually this is the one that I designate to just random eyeshadow brands. But this is an awesome size to put eyeshadows and blush in. This is a really good size for a travel palette if you have a lot of products in pan form like I do. So I highly recommend this. It's great quality and it is a really nice size. And $10 is a fantastic price. And then I had one lip product. It is the Maybelline Creamy Matte Lipstick in the shade Daringly Nude. I wore this in a video a couple weeks ago, I believe. And this is a beautiful peachy nude. I did do an entire review video on these lipsticks. I will have that linked up here. I do like this. This is fully opaque. It is a creamy matte finish, so it is more comfortable on your lips. It isn't so drying, but it looks matte. The formula of this lipstick is a little bit thick, so when you reapply, it can feel kind of heavy. I do like these but I just never reach for them. I try so many different lip products that I find that I don't really reach for my traditional lipsticks very much, but I want to get back into them because it is a good formula and I actually love this color in the fall. It's a really beautiful peach nude on my skin tone that pairs really nicely with really warm eyes. So I do recommend this. I think it is good, but I can't really say it's a favorite because I don't reach for it a ton. And then we did have a polish combination of an olive and a beautiful coppery shade. So the olive polish is Zoya's Charlie, and this is not a favorite anymore, I can tell you that. I did wear it in a video a couple weeks ago. And this is opaque in two coats. I love the Zoya formula, but this is more of like a gray, cool toned olive, and I prefer more of a golden olive. And at that time when they released this, there weren't as many options. Like olive polish was not a popular shade, but I'm thinking that I want to get Kale Polish Chloe instead whenever that comes back in stock, because that looks a little bit warmer, which I think will be more flattering on my skin tone and just fit my preferences better. It's a good formula and it's a good olive if you want something more cool tone, but if you want something more warm tone, this isn't the one for you. And then the other polish which I was using as an accent nail is OPI Worth a Pretty Penne. This is stunning. I absolutely love this. It is a gorgeous copper rose gold mixture. I love this polish so much. I think OPI makes the best metallic. They're opaque in 2 to 3 coats. They wear for a long time. And this has some little silvery glitter specks in here. It's not textured on your nails, but it just gives more dimension and makes it look metallic instead of like a chrome. I love this. I think it is beautiful. Highly, highly recommend this. It's one of my holy grail polishes, and I love wearing this one on its own or paired with other shades. And I do like this color combo, but Zoya Charlie's not a favorite anymore, but the OPI is. And then I had a random product called the Hard Candy Oopsie Proof Eyeliner Eraser, and it was basically like a makeup remover and an eyeliner pen. It was a really, really skinny, precise tip. It did a nice job, but the tip would get kind of dirty, of course, with eyeliner, and then it would smudge a little bit on your skin. And I found that it dried out incredibly quickly. For that reason, I wouldn't purchase it. I know that e.l.f. makes one, but the tip is a little bit fatter, which is why I like the Hard Candy, and it works, but it dried out way too fast, and it's not necessary for me. So no, that's no longer a favorite and it's not something I'd purchase. So guys, that was my Throwback Thursday of my November favorites from 2015. I would love to know your thoughts if you tried out any of these products. Thank you all so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye, guys.